Okay, student, now we are going to solve the exercise 2.1, question number 1. The statement of question number 1 is, identify which of the following are rational and irrational numbers. Some numbers are given, we have to find the which are the rational numbers and which are the irrational numbers. In part number 1, the value is given under root 3. If we solve under root 3, if we take the square root of under root 3, its answer is 1.732050080 and up to so on. As you know that after taking the square root, the answer is 1.732050080. So after the point, the numbers are not repeating. It means they are the non-terminating and non-recurring, because the number and division is continuously continuing. So the numbers which are not repeating, it shows that the fraction is non-terminating, and the numbers are not repeating. It means that they are the non-recurring. So the irrational numbers have two properties, that they are non-terminating and non-recurring. So by getting this answer, we get to know that the under root 3 is a irrational number. So we can say that it is an irrational number. So under root 3 is an irrational number. Now we are going to solve the second part. If we solve 1 over 6, if we divide 1 over 6, the result is 0.16666 and up to so on. So after dividing the fraction, we have the decimal, which after the point, after the 1, the number 6 is repeating again and again. It shows it's a recurring number and non-terminating. Because of recurring number, this shows that the number p over 1 over 6 is a rational number, because it's in p over q form. So it is a rational number. Because it's a recurring decimal, so it is, this fraction is a p over q form. It shows that it is a rational number. And if we solve the third part, if we solve it, as we know that the value of pi is 3.1415926 54 and up to so on. So the value of pi shows that after the point, the numbers are not repeating. It means it's a non-terminating and non-recurring, because the division is continuously going on. So it's a non-terminating and the numbers are not repeating, so it's a non-recurring. And the irrational number has the two properties, that they are non-terminating and non-recurring. So it shows that pi is a irrational number. So it is an irrational number. So in this way you can solve the question number 1, its all parts, by finding out that are they terminating or non-terminating, recurring or non-recurring. If a point has the decimal fraction, it is non-terminating and non-recurring, the number is called the irrational number. If the number is non-terminating and recurring, it is the rational number. And if the number is terminating, it is also the rational number.